you can be a fan of whoever the hell you want to be a fan of. God bless you. I don't want you to be a fan, but I just want to understand why the hate. I've never seen people like y'all know me. I don't like Karl Malone. I'm not a Karl Malone fan under any circumstances. But y'all never heard me call him a bench. Y'all never heard me call him a scrub. Y'all never heard all this vitriol from me about Karl Malone. I just think he's a bit overrated. I think he's a one-trick pony. But that, hey man, he performed the hell out of that trick. He was David Copperfield with that damn trick. So I'm not going, oh man, he wasn't shit. I just wasn't a fan. Hell, I'm not a fan, and it might shock the hell out of a bunch of people. I'm not a fan of Kevin Garnett, but 2 days ago, somebody asked me who on my all-NBA second team power forward. I said between Charles Barkley and Kevin Garnett would be number two behind Tim Duncan. Just because I'm not a fan of you don't mean I'm going to call you out your name and disregard your abilities. That's kind of foolish to me. But I just wanted to know y'all point of view in regards to that. It was just kind of stupid. It is kind of stupid that we talk about every little thing that this young man does. I'm old enough to remember when people like Jim Brown would go on Arsenio Hall and shoot Magic Johnson and Michael Jordan through the grease. Disrespect them, call them sellouts, say they ain't doing enough for the culture, they need to be doing this and that. LeBron James walked into the league, had no regard for his reputation in regards to his brand or anything of that nature, stood up for the community, and people hate him. You don't have to be a fan. You can root against him. Like I used to root against Kobe Bryant hard as hell. But you know what's the best part? I lost most of those bets. He used to kill. So I wasn't like, I mean, he a bum. He ain't shit. I don't understand that part of it. Don't be a fan. Root against him. I can't stand him. But I be seeing people write things like, "little bitch" on Facebook. He ain't shit. That's something I don't get. But maybe that's just me. Maybe. And I had another revelation. I'm going to hit what y'all think about this as well. I ain't gonna lie, man. Over the last year, I've created that second show, Build and Destroy, because I wasn't enjoying sports the way I used to. I was like, man, maybe I've matured out of this. Then I realized a couple days ago, after having one of those dumbass sports conversations, it's not the sports that I wasn't enjoying anymore. It was the conversations around sports. And people making it like these dudes, they like they Jalen Ramsey and Golden Tate, like these dudes sleeping with their sister and ain't taking care of the baby type shit. What y'all think about that? Have y'all ever not liked sports anymore due to the conversations, or is there anything that had nothing to do with sports that turns you away from sports?
It's other fan ignorance that turns you away from sports. Granted, I won't lie, I'm in a lot of state groups and stuff like that. And their ignorance in regards to the way they thought about sports and stuff like that, that turned me away from, like, man, I don't want to watch this race type thing. Because the stupidity of them is just going through my head. But of course, I end up blocking that out and remember what I'm here for, just entertainment.
Right.
I stopped debating with people. I got on this show so I can talk about sports the way I feel like. So it's like, I don't have to debate with nobody no more.
I kind of feel like Joe McGriff. You have people, because I'm in a couple of Chicago Cubs and Chicago Bears groups on Facebook, and it's some of the stuff that they say in there, you'd be like, what team are y'all watching?
Right.
So, I mean, it kind of turned you off as far as even bringing up something, the subject, to even be like, hey, man, did you check out Sunday's game? Like, yeah. Hey, man, dude needs to come off this block, man. Or he needs to do this. He needs to do that. All right, man. But, I mean, it don't turn me off from the sport. It's just like you said, sometimes I, like, snooze that group for a while, so I won't see none of those big conversations pop up. But, I mean, no, it don't turn me off from the sport, though. Some people, you gotta realize you can't have a conversation with them about sport, especially a lot of Chicago Bulls and the Chicago Bears fans. I don't know, they delusional as fuck.
Man, I mean.
One of the ways Chicago Bulls fans stop talking, and Michael Jordan coming back tomorrow.
Yeah, man.
Granted, the 90s were great. Yes, the 90s were great. But that's over with. That's over with, dude.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, man, I ain't going to lie to you, man. That's why I created the Build and Destroy show. I was like, I can't. This shit is too stupid. I literally felt that way. I was like, man. Because I ain't going to lie, y'all. To me, about 50% of the fun in watching sports was debating about what I just saw. And it was like y'all just said. It was like, hey, man, what the fuck are y'all watching? And it was like, hold it. Are people really this stupid at this point? And I know that makes me sound like I'm think I'm smarter than motherfuckers, but it's like y'all said, the verbiage that y'all use is perfect. Delusional. It's like, bruh, what are you watching? And it was like, nah, I can't do this no more. But after having that conversation this weekend and just realizing, oh man, you just full of shit. You ain't stupid, you just full of shit. And I was just like, oh, that's the way people do it now. And so now I'm more engaged in sports than I have been in the last, I ain't gonna lie, last two years. I have not been as engaged because it's like, man, I'm not for this shit. This shit's stupid now. When you start comparing motherfuckers like John Starks to LeBron and, you know, LeBron ain't shit. And then those same people that tell me LeBron ain't shit will stick up for one of these garbage-ass Chicago Bear quarterbacks. And it's like, are you fucking crazy? Like, I don't like the Cubs. I'm not a Cub fan, but I don't not like them. But I'm not going, man, Chris Brown a bum. What? Shut up. So, I'm re-engaging. I think I'm really getting my zest back for sports, and I hope it continues to stay. Because I really like debating about sports. I like doing this show. I like having a good time with y'all. So I think you know, y'all coming on the show kind of revitalized my, you know, gave me more energy in regards to sports. And then engage with people like, you know, people in the chat room and stuff like that, and going to other people's shows and see that you can still have an intelligent debate with somebody on sports without hearing some stupid shit like, oh man, Joe Montana won shit. You know, just shut the hell up. No, Jeff George would have won the MVP. You know, but, and okay, before we tune out, this is a question that me and Joe talk about a lot, and I actually never asked. We talk about this a lot, but I never really asked them, so I'm going to ask both of y'all the question, then we're going to tune out, then pardon shots. Do you guys think shows like First Take and Nick Wright and those guys, do y'all think those shows ruin sport conversations?
Yes, I hate watching those shows. Yes. Yeah. And the bad part about it is that some of those shows, like Skip and Shun, I love watching. I love when Shannon put box Skip into a corner. And then, you know, Skip just start throwing out all bunch of BS. That's why I find enjoyment. That's when I'm like, you know what? This is why I watch the show. Because, I mean, but besides that, like, I haven't watched First Take in probably like 2 years because I can't stand Stephen A. Sorry, Max Kellerman, but that's your partner. But as far as it goes, I look for, like I said, for Shannon to put Skip in the box.
Yeah, but I just can't take Skip sometimes. It's just too. I understand that he tried to be the contrarian for the sake of argument, but that shit is just, sometimes I turn from that shit, man. And Stephen A. is always telling how Max, how dumb his thought process is. Like, man, who the hell are you? Motherfucker. And I don't, as a moderator, I like that other chick that he sent out there for her. That's the chick that he built. Anyway, I digress. But, I like to watch. I think I'll watch Kiffner before I'll watch First Take. Because, even if one day he's going to be the pro black, and this is what black people need to hear, and then the next day, this is what the white people need to hear. Dude, it's a sports show, man. Sports is one of the only things where we can actually sit back and sit with a white motherfucker, with a fucking alien, and as long as they understand what the fuck is going on in the game, we can have a conversation about it. Hey, man, that's nothing, man. When I played this game, this is not what we did, man. Don't throw them. Try to go over the top when you see the safety standing right there. You know, feel like that, but yeah, I mean, I think it's all about the producers, man, and the content that these people want to talk about on Twitter, man. That's all what it's about. Shock value. Talk about sports, man.
Like,
all I want to know is this. Once Tom Brady retires in the next few years and LeBron retires in the next few years, what is Skip going to talk about?
Sorry, Skip going to bring up LeBron.
Yeah, but I still enjoy Tony and I don't know if y'all do, but I still pardon the interruption. Because as Big Illinois just said, they actually talk about sports. You know, they get political when it's time. They give you they give two honest opinions. A lot of the times they don't agree, and I like that. But like you said, it ain't a show. It ain't I'm gonna get loud and I'm gonna be Fred Hampton today. But I'm gonna be, you know, no disrespect, but I'm gonna use this as other people have used. I'm gonna be Sammy Davis Jr. another day. I'm not calling Sammy Davis Jr. sellout or anything, but he did have that label at one time. But, you know, you can't be Fred Hampton one day and then, you know, caping for the man next, you know. So, like you said, and Skip Bayless is the most ridiculous sports opinion giver in the history of television. But, as I stated, that's one of the reasons I was turned off, because I tell Joe this all the time. Joe, you're not here. He'd be like, man, check this dumbass debate out. And I tell him all the time, Joe, you know you're not debating with that person. You're debating with Skip Bayless. I tell him all the time. Because they not, you know, anytime your entire conversation is Jordan got six rings, Tom Brady got six rings, that's why he the best. But Jordan got six rings and undefeated, and he the best. And Joe Montana got four rings, never threw interception, but Tom Brady the best, which is kind of stupid. But I just want to know, man, but like I said, man, I want to thank you, brothers, man, for breathing life back into my whole sports get down, because that was my number one form of entertainment. That's how, 20-something years ago, that's how me and Juice, or y'all know him as Kirby for the listeners, that's how me and Kirby became friends over 20-something years ago, literally sitting in the barbershop for hours at a time, laughing and joking about sports. And I got one of my closest friends in the whole world because we never agreed, but it was always a good conversation. And then, and I said this once and I said it 1,000 times, I was already considering starting my own show. And Kirby, a.k.a. Big Juice, he was like, man, you should start your own show. And I said, damn. And I told him, I said, you know what, bro? I've been working on it on my own. I've been thinking about that. And here we are almost 5 years later. I definitely made up stuff.